I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me,
lose my mind. 8:07, welcome back to the KNews Morning Show. My name is Kevin Holmes.
I'm Mike Mazingo.
And that song you're playing, Mazinga, right now is fantastic. And folks, listen up. If you are a rock music fan, you are undoubtedly familiar with such major artists as Harry Nilsson, Little Richard, The Turtles, Ringo Starr, Jimmy Webb, Stills and Crofts, Frank Zappa. The list goes on and on. What you probably don't know is that all of them at one point in their career crossed paths with our next guest that's on the phone with us right now, and that would be Andy Kahn. Good morning, Andy. How are you doing?
Kevin and Mike, thank you guys so much for having me on your show. I'm excited and thrilled and can't wait.
We totally appreciate it. And you have what you call a rock and roll scrapbook, right? It's called The Most Famous Musician You've Never Heard Of, right?
Yes, I'm very excited about it. It's selling like hotcakes. It was released in April. And if you recall, when Bill was around, I was on your show a couple of times talking about it. Mm-hmm. And it finally came out, and it's doing very well. I got a lot of 5-star reviews on Amazon, and several rock and roll magazines gave me really good reviews. So I'm very excited about it.
Andy, you've worked with some really fantastic and amazing artists in the music industry. So can you give us a couple of stories? I mean, like, I want you to dish on some of these people. Seriously.
Oh yeah. Well, Harry Nilsson and I became very close friends after we met doing a radio show on K-Rock in New York with Flo and Eddie of the Turtles. So I was able to record 35 songs in my living room with Harry Nilsson, which some of them
songs?
Were chosen on a 4-track cassette.
Wow. And, we miss those days, don't we, Andy? Come on, seriously. those days.
One of them was used in a movie called Me, Myself, and I with George Segal and Joe Beth Williams. And Harry and I went to the premiere, we were laughing because it sounded so incredibly terrific on the theater speakers. And we knew we recorded it on a 4-track cassette. So that was really funny for us. But one of the highlights was a premonition that I had. Back in 1968, I had a premonition that a beetle came over to my house, and he sat next to me, and he took his shoes off. And later on in 1991, Harry Nilsson brought Ringo Starr over to my house.
Wow.
And we recorded some children's stories that Van Dyke Parks and Harry and myself we're going to put the music to, and it was a very hot day, and we turned off the air conditioner so it wouldn't get picked up by the mic, and Ringo sat right next to me, and he took his shoes off.
I was going to ask, did he take the shoes off? Because that's what really makes the premonition come to life, you know.
That was amazing, and he was just the most sweetest guy ever. You know, I didn't want to bug him and ask him all these stories about the Beatles, but he did tell me one story that Paul McCartney was on an airplane with Mal Evans, who was the Beatles road manager, and Paul told Mal, hey, you know, I want to do an album of a fictitious band, you know, a make-believe band that's not the Beatles, and we want to do like a story album, you know, so what do you think? And Mal Evans says, how about Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band? So those are the words of Ringo Starr in my living room telling Harry and I about this amazing creation of Sgt. Pepper.
That was one of my favorite albums of all time. I just don't let you know. I used to smoke a lot of pot when I was in high school to that album.
Oh, man, me too. Well, I took acid. I took
me too.
Timothy Leary's pharmacist.
Oh, we have a lot in common, Andy.
Timothy Leary's pharmacist was named Osley, and I used to take purple Osley every day for the summer of 1967.
Wow.
And I'm still talking. I can't believe it.
That brings back some memories for sure, Andy, for definitely.
Amazing stuff.
So, Andy, you know, I'm looking at your book here, and like we said when we introduced you, you've worked with so many amazing, legendary artists. But take us back to the beginning. How did it all start? How did, you know, your love of music begin? How did you kind of get your foot in the door of the music industry?
It was very interesting. I was told by my sister about the Ed Sullivan Show, and I watched it, and I saw the Beatles. And that completely changed my life like it did with everybody else.
I was going to say, I feel like there's probably a lot of people out there who, when they first saw the Beatles, it changed everything for them.
Yeah, and as a matter of fact, I wanted to be a Beatle. I had curly hair at the time. And so I went to the pharmacy and I bought Perma-Straight, you know, so I can get a straight hair Beatle haircut. And it worked really, really well for about an hour. And then my hair frizzed up into this gigantic ball of broken hair, but I started a band, and we played all these battle of bands, and we did really well, and I played a Farfisa combo compact organ, and later a record company in Los Angeles released a record called Johnny Farfisa, and instead of Johnny Rotten, it was Johnny Farfisa, because I played a Farfisa organ. But in any event, I moved to from New York to California in 1968, and I worked for my mom's good friend's record company called Pulsar Records. And Dr. John the Night Tripper and Graham Bond were some of the acts on the label. And my job was gopher. I was, you know, driving the VW bus and picking the musicians up for the recording sessions and taking pictures for Billboard and Cashbox and getting the coffee and all that. So Graham calls me up and says, get your harpsichord, and we got a recording session coming up, a jam session. So I pick up Graham, and we go to the TTG Studios on Sunset Boulevard in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. And Lowell George from Little Feet was on the flute. Graham Bond was on the organ. Jack Cassidy from the Jefferson Airplane was on bass. Mitch Mitchell was setting up the drums. And then all of a sudden, I feel something behind me, and Jimi Hendrix walks in.
Oh, my God.
With two blonde chicks, one carrying his amp and one carrying his guitar. And he sets up right next to me. So here I am, 20 years old, with Jimi Hendrix and all these amazing musicians. And we did a two-hour recording session of the blues in the key of A.
Cool.
Yeah, just 2 weeks after I moved to L.A., I was in the studio with Jimi Hendrix. Unbelievable.
Just to let everyone know, we are talking to the most famous musician you've never heard of, and that would be Andy Kahn. And you have worked with some fantastic people, and we love the fact that you joined us this morning. And it's just, I mean, the people that you've met and run into, I mean, you just must be so happy with the life that you've led. I mean, quite honestly, it's really, it sounds so amazing.
Well, I'm extremely grateful that I saved all my archives. All the photographs and contracts and letters and posters and stickers and calendars. And that made it really easy to build this book. And it is like a rock and roll scrapbook. Each page has a different story on it. It's really incredible. It's really
and Andy, really
book.
Quick, I'm sorry, we got to cut this short, but we appreciate you joining us so much. Can you tell us really quick how people can get in touch with you and how people can get the book, The Most Famous Musician You've Never Heard Of?
All they have to do is Google The Most Famous Musician You've Never Heard Of.
Easy.
And it'll take you to, there's several websites, including Amazon, the best classic rock bands, and all these websites that have, information about how to get the book.
Andy, thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate it very, very much, and we'll talk to you again soon, okay?
All right, you guys. Thank you so very much for having me on.
94.3 104.7.